Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Michael, helping you get the most out of your Apple devices. In today's video, I want to do something kind of fun. I want to take a look back at the good old days of iOS 6. So nowadays, we kind of get caught up with all the new features and all the new phones, like iOS 12 and all the new betas coming out. I'm still interested in that, but I want to do something sort of different today and just take a look back at the very, very old iOS version. iOS 6. So this is six versions old when iOS 12 comes out. And that is a pretty long time ago. When I think back to iOS 6, I don't think that it was six iOS releases ago, but it actually was. This is back in the day when Steve Jobs loved this skeuomorphic design, when the photos icon had an actual photo of a flower, when Notification Center had this actual texture. And all the icons look different. The design of iOS was completely different. And I just want to go through iOS 6 and look at some of my favorite applications and to see how much they have changed over the years. So in this video, we're going to go ahead and take a look at iOS 6. So starting here on the lock screen, the first thing you can see is that classic iOS 6 water wallpaper. It's just a wave formation. I like that. Apple still does water wallpapers. That's nothing new. We do have this quick camera shortcut here. We still have camera shortcuts on iOS 12, but I think that's a swipe from right to left to get to the camera now. So if you want to access the camera in iOS 6, you just swipe up. I believe in iOS 5, you actually have to double click the home button to reveal this camera shortcut. But here on iOS 6, you can just swipe up and there's the camera. You can just see there all that lifelike animations in iOS 6 where you, when you open the camera, you can see there that those shutters kind of open like that. That is really cool. And it just seems like Apple put more effort and more care into the design and the animations they were doing. It just seemed like every little pop-up box that came up, every little animation, really, it looks like they took their time. So I kind of miss iOS 6. And let's take a look at some of the actual applications now. Weather, I really like. I think they were using a different weather service in iOS 6. I think they're using the Weather Channel now in iOS 12. They were using Yahoo back in the day. And I remember Yahoo was actually so much more accurate, and I still use Yahoo for my weather now. You can see here, there's no animations like in iOS 11, iOS 12. It's just basic cards here. Like I said, that realistic lifelike icons are still showing up here. Like these 3 days, we're going to get a thunderstorm. You can see here, it's an actual picture of clouds and lightning. And the sun looks like the actual sun with real clouds. And you can see there's an actual picture of the moon. So skeuomorphism is kind of bringing the idea of what objects look like in real life to the digital world. So they want to make it look as real as possible. And obviously that is completely different now with iOS 12. You may notice that we do have a videos application. The videos app doesn't actually exist anymore in iOS. It is now called the TV app. You can actually sign in with your TV provider and watch all your shows. You can stream them. That is completely different. The videos application was strictly for watching music videos and movies that you downloaded from iTunes. So you can see here we have the iTunes store. The icon is still purple, so that is still the same. But you can see here we have TV shows, movies, and music. And this was the only way you could actually get your music on iOS 6. There was no Apple Music until iOS 8. So speaking of music, let's go into the music application, or the iPod as it was called back then, and take a look. So you can see here we have playlists, artists, songs, albums, and more. This is kind of the same as the music app is now. I really love the now playing screen. You can see here, I like these chrome buttons, and actually the end of this music toggle reacted to the way you move the phone. I can't get it to work on this iOS version, but apparently in another version, an older version of iOS 6, whenever you move the phone, this little chrome toggle would react. If you want to get the scrubber to scrub through your song, all you have to do is tap on the screen, because the screen was so small that you actually couldn't have the scrubber showing at the same time as all your controls, because it would cover up the album art and Steve Jobs would not stand for that. So you have to tap to show your scrubber. It has CoverFlow if you turn it, but I only have one album downloaded here from iTunes, so I can't really show you CoverFlow, but it was there, and this was the last iOS release that had CoverFlow, I think. iOS 7 might have had it. You can correct me in the comments if I'm wrong. Let's go ahead and take a look at a few more applications. Maps. Maps is so awesome for that skeuomorphic design. Take a look at this. I'm actually peeling back the map to reveal more buttons. If this isn't old classic Apple, I don't know what is. And you can see that texture underneath this little peeled up map here. The same thing as in the Notification Center. So they did like this this texture. I don't know what this is supposed to be, this gray jean-like texture, but they did love using this. And I just love how you can play with this and peel it back. And you just don't see that attention to detail anymore in iOS 12 or just the modern iOS versions as Apple tries to make them super simple. Like I mentioned before, the detail in the photos icon is just a flower, but since it's a Retina display on the small screen, you can just look up and see all the details in that photos icon. Also the camera, you can see there that there's a lens flare on the actual camera lens icon, and it just looks so good, and I really do like how iOS 6 looked. Another small thing, you can see that the clock icon is not live, so I don't think Apple added the live clock to the home screen until iOS 7, 8, or 9. It's one of those versions, you can tell me in the comments down below, but it was just a regular clock icon, you couldn't actually get the time on your home screen. Inside settings here, you can tell me that it is, you can see that it is telling me to upgrade to iOS 8.4.1. I'm not going to be doing that because my iPhone 4S is running so much better on iOS 6. iOS 8 and iOS 9 completely ruined this phone. But if you do want Apple Music, you can upgrade to iOS 8.4.1. So that is kind of funny. Let's take a look at some of the wallpapers because I don't remember the wallpapers that were in iOS 6. Boy, this brings back memories. So if you're my age or a bit older and you remember using your iPhone 4S on iOS 6, you can just remember these wallpapers and these huge buttons with the huge shadow and the big outline around them. Just look at that attention to detail. It just looks so nice on the Retina display. When you click a button, it really feels like you're clicking it. I don't know why. It just feels so much better than iOS 12 right now. The buttons are so huge and the shadow that they put on it. It just feels so much better. I don't know if that's just me getting excited for iOS 6 and getting all nostalgic, but sometimes the UI elements in the older versions, they can work out better than they do right now. I don't know why this wallpaper was in iOS 6. It's kind of weird, but you can't zoom in on wallpapers. I don't think you can do that now either. But yeah, guys, this really brings me back. And the camera roll, that was it. There was no separate albums, there was no portrait mode, there were no portrait lighting features. It was just camera roll and the places that you took them, and you could just scroll through them like this. And if you want to trash a photo, you can see here that menu comes up really fast, and there are those huge buttons that when you press them, it really feels like you're pressing them. And that's really cool. You get that animation how it just goes into the trash bin. You can see how that trash bin just opens up and it goes in. So that attention to detail, you just don't see anymore in the days of iOS 12. And it is fun to look back at iOS 6. Of course, iOS 12 is going to be a better operating system, more features, more bells and whistles, more stability. But just looking back at the days of iOS 6, like the way it looked, the icons, all the subtle animations, I really do miss it. So thanks so much for watching. If you have anything to say about this video, if you miss iOS 6 also, drop a line in the comments down below. My name is Michael, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.